Hello and the warmer welcome student in the new lecture of the thermodynamics. Today we will be learning the lecture number 6. But students, before we move ahead, it is necessary to revise some previous part so you can keep in mind very easily and for the long time. So I will revise in short time impact the previous part of the lecture. So students, first diagram we have discussed is increase in internal energy. So here you can see in this diagram that the amount of heat transfer from the environment into the system is 200 joule, and the work done is by the system on the environment, it is 100 joule. So simply you can put this value in the equation of first law of thermodynamics, then you will get delta U is equal to Q minus W. So you can put the value easily that Q is equal to 200 and W is equal to 100 joule, then you will get 100 joule. So thus you can say the increase in internal energy is with the amount of 100 joule. Thus, along with that, we can conclude that if more heat is added to the system than the work done by it, that in delta U means the internal energy will be increased and it will be greater than the zero. So this is the thing we can conclude in the point of increase in internal energy with the help of the diagram and some explanatory points. Now students, second part we have seen is the decrease in internal energy. Now in this point you can see the diagram, the work done in the system, work done on the system by the environment, it is minus 100 joule, while the heat transfer from the system into the environment, it is minus 200 joule. Thus simply you can put the value of W and Q in the equation of first law of thermodynamics, then you will get delta U is equal to Q minus W. So Q will be minus 200 and W will be minus 100. Then you will get minus 100 joule of internal energy, which is degrees, which will be degrees, which is less than the zero. Now last but not the least, the point is no change in internal energy. In this article we can say that the delta U is equal to zero means the amount of work done on the system and the amount of heat leaving the system, it is exactly the same, means the amount is the 200 joule. Then you can directly put this value into the first law of thermodynamic equation, then you will get the value of delta U is equal to zero, means the no heat transfer will be there. In short, we can say that the both the system, means the system and the environment, are in thermal equilibrium. They have achieved the state of the thermal equilibrium. So students, these are the things that we have discussed in the previous lecture. Now we will move ahead for the next part of the chapter. Now the next part is thermodynamic state variable and the equation of state. Specific values of macroscopic variables. For example, the equilibrium state of the ball is completely described by the value of pressure, temperature and the volume and the mass. So students, as you can see in the diagram, the initial state of the ball and the final state of the ball, when the ball was not having the air inside it, and the state of the ball in which the ball was full of the air, you can see the two states of the balls. Then these all parameters of the ball you can measure with the help of the pressure of the ball, pressure of the air inside the ball, and the temperature and the volume of ball which has been occupied by the air inside the ball, and the total it will be affected on the mass of the ball. So by this help of this whole entire quantities, you can describe the equilibrium state of the ball. So students, let me explain one more time. When the initial state of the ball, when there was no air inside the ball, then there was lack of volume, the volume was less, and the air contained by that ball in it was also too less than that of the final one, and the temperature of the ball will also vary less, and the pressure is also, the pressure of the air inside the ball, it was also, that one also was the less than that of the final one. But when you compare the final state of the ball from the initial one, then the pressure of the gases inside the ball has been increased, and the temperature also of the ball has also increased, and the volume which has been occupied by the air inside the ball, that has been also increased, and this all changes will give rise to the last quantity, that is the mass, will also change, or you can say it will increase, as the amount of air contained in that ball has been increased rather than that of the final initial state one. In students, with the help of this ball, with the help of this example of the ball, we can say that the pressure P, volume V, and the temperature T, and the mass M can be used to measure the final and initial state of the ball. Hence, consider a mixture of gas or a vapor as in case of fuel in an automobile engine. Its state can be described by the state variables, but we also need its composition to describe its state. That's why we can say these types of variables we are using to describe the final and initial state of the system or any object, those variables are called as a thermodynamic state variables. So students, in short, in a simple words, the thermodynamic state variables describe the equilibrium state of the system. So as we are already aware of that, the equilibrium state of the system has been described with the help of the final and initial state of the system. So in between those two systems, then we can describe with the help of their comparatively parameters, and those parameters we are using pressure, volume, temperature and mass. These are the different types of parameters or the variables we are using to describe the final and initial state of the system. That's why these are also called as a thermodynamic state variables of the system. Now students, we will be seeing the equation of state. But the first of all, the state of equation means equation of state can be defined as the mathematical equation or the mathematical relation between the state variables. State variables is called as an equation of state. The students, relation between the state variables is called as an equation of state. For example, for an ideal gas, the equation of state is the ideal gas equation, which is PV is equal to nRT. In this equation of ideal gas, we can say that the P is nothing but the pressure, V is the volume, N is the number of moles, R is the gas constant, and T is the temperature. Now students, we are going to learn how to represent the typical PV diagram. PV diagram means the graph between the pressure and the volume we are going to see, and how to represent that we will see now. Now students, we'll be learning the typical PV diagram. So this is the diagram that we have to learn here. Now you can see the pressure and volume graph has been represented, in which the pressure is represented on the y-axis while the volume is represented on the x-axis. And the typical values of the pressure P1, P2 and the intermediate value of P has been represented. And after that, the value of volumes on x-axis like a V1, V2 has been represented on the x-axis. So students, as you can see the first value, the value of the volume on the x-axis and the value of the pressure on the y-axis can intersect at the point. At the first point you can see. After that, at the point A you can observe. As you will observe the point A, then you will be able to see that the value of pressure is higher and the value of volume is constant. The value of volume is constant. So at the point A, the value of volume is constant and the value of pressure has been increased from the initial to final. The value of pressure has been increased. So these coordinates have been indicated as the V1 and the P1. V1, P1 are the coordinate of point A, at which the value of pressure is higher while the value of volume is the constant, as you can see in this graph, PV graph. So at the point B, you can observe the value of volume and the pressure, means the coordinate of the point B will be V2 and the P2. So you can observe the value of pressure has been decreased, means it comes to point A to B and it has been in the curve shape, so it has been decreased. And now you can see the value of volume, it has been increased drastically, means continuous change in the volume of V, while in the inverse manner the continuous decrease in the value of the pressure, as you can see. So you can say value at point B, the value of pressure is decreasing continuously while the value of volume has been increased up to the point V2. So when you conclude the point A and the point B, there will be the curve will be formed, as it will be indication or the representation of the typical PV diagram, as you can see on your screen. So like the students, we'll be seeing the different types of cases in which positive work with the varying pressure, negative work with the varying P, and the positive work at a constant pressure. So these types of cases are there, which we are going to learn one by one with the typical PV graph representation. Now students, we'll be seeing the positive work with the varying pressure. So as you can see the graph on your screen, typical PV representation of the positive work with the varying pressure. So as according to the typical PV diagram representation, the pressure is indicated in the y-axis while the volume is indicated on the x-axis. So the typical values of the pressure P1 and P2 has been represented on the y-axis, while the typical values of the volume V1 and V2 has been represented on the x-axis. So students, as you can see in the graph, in the typical representation of PV diagram of the positive work with the varying pressure, the value is given as 1 to 2, means, and the arrow is coming downward. So we can say that the P1 is given at the point 1 and the V1 is the stable, means constant value of the volume, and the V1 is the constant. So as the value of pressure is only increased and the value of V1, that is value of first volume, has been constant, so we can say at point 1 the value of at point 1 it is, or the coordinates of the point 1 will be P1 V1, as you can see in the diagram representation. While on the other point, that is point 2, the value of the pressure is P2 and the value of the volume is V2. So you can see here students that the value of pressure is constant and the value of volume has been increased, and you can guess if the value of the volume is increased. So what we can say, if the volume increases, then when it is possible? Suppose you have one object in your hand and its volume suddenly get increased, then what will happen? As its volume will increase, so the air inside that object will also increase. So in short you can say it is expand. So this is nothing but the expansion of gas. So students, as you can see, the point 1 to 2 has been indicated with the arrow, and as there is a state changing from point 1 to 2, the pressure has been decreasing, and it reaches at the point 2 where the pressure will be constant, and suddenly from the constant value of the volume it comes to the increasing volume, means it is nothing but the expansion of gas inside the cylinder, and the piston movement will be towards the opposite of the cylinder. This is what we can conclude, and we can say that this is nothing but the positive work, as the work has been done by the system on the piston, that we can at that time we say that the work is positive. We have already learned about that, and this is nothing but the typical PV representation of the positive work with the varying pressure. Now student, so the work done is carried by the system, work done has been done by the system on the environment, as the piston movement is toward the its opposite of the cylinder. So the work has been done on this by the system on the environment. So we can say that work done is nothing but the increase in area, it is nothing but the expansion of gas inside the cylinder, and it will give rise to the increase in area of that cylinder as the piston moves outward. So we can say the work done will be equal to the area that has been occupied by the force which has been applied on the piston, and the displacement of piston will give rise to the area which has been obtained by the work done on that piston by the system with the help of the gas. Now students, as the work is equal to area, so we can mathematically represent it as the work has been given rise to the area of that cylinder which has been expanded by the gas, it will be integration of dW, that is integration of small amount of work done by the gases on that piston and which has given rise to the expansion. It will be nothing but the integration of dW from the V1 to VF, which will further can be written as integration of PdV from the V1 to VF. So this we can say that the P is nothing but the pressure which has been exerted by that gases on the piston and which has given rise to the small increase in volume. So we can write it as W is equal to integration of dW from V1 to Vf is equal to integration of PdV from the V1 to Vf. So students, this is the part which we have learned in this video, that the positive work with the bearing pressure with the help of the PV diagram with the easy and simple way. Now the next part of this chapter we will see in the next video. Thank you so much, students.